What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Abby, if you are new. Today's video is going to be focused on all of the things that I wish I would have known before I started my natural hair journey. So if you're a person who is starting their natural hair journey or is thinking about starting their natural hair journey, then I think this video will be a perfect fit for you. But before I dive into the nitty and gritty details of this video, I would love for you to go down below, take one quick second and click that like and subscribe button, because all we have is good content and good hair products over here, girl, okay? Basically, I wanted to share a couple of things that I was thinking about, because I know it's really easy to come on YouTube and find a whole bunch of people who already know what to do with their hair and have discovered all the great things that they do with their hair, and you're kind of just like,
what? What is diffusing? What is LOC and LCO? Why I gotta use all these products to get my hair looking good?
I know what that feels like. I know what it's like to kind of be in a loss and trying to figure out all these new terms and all that. The first thing I'd like to say is that natural hair should not be difficult. A lot of people try to create different things for natural hair to kind of like spice up whatever's going on within the natural hair community, but to be honest, your natural hair journey is literally whatever you make it. So the first tip that I have for anyone who's thinking about going natural is to know how you want to start your natural hair journey. You have two options. Number one, big chop, cut it all off, start your life over. When a woman cuts her hair, she's about to change her life, all that good stuff. That's one route you could go. Or you can go in the transitioning way, which is let your hair grow out. And as it grows out, you start cutting off little by little. Now, you know you more than anyone knows you. You know what you can deal with. As for me, I decided that I wanted to big chop. I wanted to cut all my hair off and just start fresh. Now, granted, I was going through a heartbreak. Some boy tried me and I wasn't having it. And I was like, I'm gonna cut all my hair off because I wanna change my life and I wanna be a new woman. And oh my God. That was my route, because I was in the transitioning phase of my life. And in order for me to feel like I was accomplishing something, I had to cut my hair off. Now, if you're one of those people who can't see yourself with short hair, can't find yourself, you're gonna cry yourself to sleep every single night because hell no, this is not me, transition, okay? The only thing I would say when it comes to transitioning is that it will be difficult when your hair really starts growing out and you have like your beautiful natural coils and curls, and then you have like your relaxed burnt hair. But ultimately, you can do some protective styling or try different ways to style your hair to avoid going through the ugly phase of transitioning and all that good stuff. The first year of your natural hair growing out and just becoming is a year of discovery. It's the year that you're gonna figure out what your hair likes, what it doesn't like, how it curls, what products to use, all that good stuff. And a part of discovering what works best for your hair is spending money on products. A lot of times you're gonna spend money on products that don't necessarily correlate well with your hair. What works for one person does not work for everyone else. And I feel like that's where a lot of people go wrong. They come on YouTube and they go on Instagram and they wanna do exactly what the influencer or the person is doing with their hair. And when they don't get the same results, they're blaming it on the influencer. Now that's kind of like a little rant, but you need to find the things that work best for you and your hair. What you can afford, what you think is best for your hair. So just prepare yourself to spend a lot of money on buying products, because your first year is gonna be a year of trial and error. Some good brands that you possibly can use that are more on the affordable side are brands like Cream of Nature, African Pride, there's a lot of body products. There's so many different brands out there that are aimed to be affordable and for different types of coils and curls and all that. So it's just a matter of doing your research. When you are going into your natural hair journey, you want to stay away from heat. Throw away the blow dryer, throw away the curling iron, throw away the flat iron. I know it's tempting, but if you are putting heat in your hair while it's growing out in its natural state, you're doing just as much damage as if you were relaxing, because then you're going to become dependent on that flat iron, on that blow dryer, and you're trying to avoid that so that your hair can flourish and grow out in its best form. Throw away everything that has heat. Just throw it away. It ain't your friend no more. It don't want to be your friend. Your hair doesn't want it to be its friend. So just pala basura. Garbage, okay? The hardest thing about entering into the natural hair journey is finding the strength to actually go through with it. Now, if you decide to big chop like I did, you have no choice but to go through with it because you ain't got no hair and you gotta wait for it to grow. I'm not gonna say that you're gonna jump into this natural hair journey and you're gonna love every stage of it and you're gonna feel beautiful throughout everything. When I big chopped my hair, I cried the first 3 months. And I put on so much makeup to hide away from the fact that my hair was short. I was trying to distract everything from my hair and just putting it on my face. You're gonna be tempted to perm. You're gonna be tempted. You're gonna cry. You're gonna feel like, what the heck did I do? And I'm not saying this is for everyone. I'm saying some people might feel this way. So just prepare yourself to feel those feelings, but also snap out of them and get right back to it, honey. You're beautiful. Okay, you're gonna try protective styles, you're gonna try box braids, you're gonna try knotless braids, you're gonna try spring twists, you're gonna go and explore and find everything that works best for your hair and find things that will kind of just put your mind away from looking at your short hair for a while. The last thing that I would suggest is to surround yourself with positivity. Follow natural hair influencers and people whose hair is just like yours or similar to yours. Find people that you can relate to. Don't try to follow these influencers, not yet at least, that have this long, beautiful hair or that their hair is exactly where they want it to be and you're kind of struggling to figure out where you want to be with your hair, or like you're struggling to find styles that work best for you. I would definitely suggest to do your research and find that one person that you can relate to, that has similar hair to you, that you can style your hair like they style their hair. One of the best things that I did was discovering Jayla Majette in the beginning of my natural hair journey. She big chopped and her experience was so raw, and I loved it because she didn't love her hair at first. She didn't know what to do with it at first, but then as it grew out, you know, she learned how to love it, and I realized that my texture and her texture were very similar. So I took on a lot of the tips and everything that she would do, the styles that she would try, I would try, and I just felt better about my hair. I felt more comfortable being able to see myself through someone else and feeling like I'm not the only person in the world who's going through this phase. So yeah, that brings us to the end of this video. I know it was a very straightforward video, but it was mostly aimed to my ladies who are kind of struggling with trying to start their natural hair journey and not knowing the things that they need to know or the things that they would like to know in order to start their journey. Your journey will be different than anyone else's journey. You can never find someone who will go through exactly the same things that you probably will go through. At the end of the day, it's hair. It will grow back. El pelo malo no existe. Bad hair does not exist. You're beautiful, and that's all that matters. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. Please be sure to go down below, like, comment, subscribe, and make sure to be back. So I'll see you in my next one.